high motivators are some people who have a vision bigger than them that are going to change the world and make a difference in a culture. That's the highest form of motivation. Right underneath purpose motivation or duty motivation is what's called personal conviction motivation. We call these people self-starters. This is entrepreneurial motivation. This is when you say, I'm going to do this because I said I was going to do it. Still a high form of motivation, but not the highest form. But what we know, that people who have purpose motivation naturally are personally convicted. Their personal conviction is in alignment with their purpose because they have a reason to get up every day. The next form of motivation is called ethics motivation or morality-based motivation. This is not the highest form of motivation, and this is based on polarity, good and bad, right and wrong. And people then, you know, they're trying to be good, but they're really bad. And they swing back and forth. They preach one thing and they do something else. And a lot of the models that are based on, well, a lot of models are based on this. But we know from our research that people who have purpose motivation have a vision that's bigger than them, that are personally convicted, have a great sense of morality, a great sense of ethics because it falls right in alignment. The next form of motivation is called ego-centered motivation. This is for acclaim and recognition and importance. But we know then that that's not a very high form of motivation and it never lasts. But people who have purpose motivation, have personal convictions, have a strong sense of ethics, naturally receive recognition. It's the end product. Now look at the lowest form of motivation. What does that say? Money motivation. People who are money motivated, you will spot them out in a crowd because they are selfish in their endeavors. They will take care of themselves first before they take care of others. It's the lowest form of motivation, but our research shows if you have a vision that's bigger than you, that's to change something, where you contribute to the whole, you have strong personal conviction, a strong sense of ethics, already receiving recognition and don't even need it, the money always comes. It's the natural flow. And we call that, in our work, affluence. You know what the word affluence means? To flow to you. People who are affluent don't go and get anything. People who are affluent have it come to them. That's who they are. It's a reflection of their state of being. How many people are with me? So then, when you have a purpose or a vision or a mission or an intent that's bigger than you, it means, it signifies something that's ongoing. You could have a purpose to go east, and there's never an end to east. You could have a purpose to be healthy. There's always more health to have. You could have a purpose to be wealthy. There's never an end to wealth. You could have a purpose for knowledge, and there's never an end to knowledge. It signifies a direction. My purpose is to transform individuals in order to transform a culture. And I'm clear on that purpose, and it gets me up in the morning every single day. So then, how do you bring a vision from the world of possibility into the world of reality? From thought all the way down into matter. From what we say in quantum physics, from the wave of possibilities all the way down into the particle, from the immaterial, something that doesn't exist yet, into the material, from the world beyond the senses to the world of the senses. How do we do that? Well, it requires then setting up goals in alignment with your purpose. So let's just say you have a purpose to go in a certain direction. Your purpose signifies a direction, but your goals should always be in alignment with your purpose. And people who have goals in alignment with their purpose, their goals are a natural side effect of them being on purpose. What do I mean by that? Let's just say you live in the United States and you are living in Los Angeles and your purpose was to go east. So you may set up the first goal to go from Los Angeles to Arizona. That's a short-term goal. And if you arrived at Flagstaff, Arizona, you would know that you were on purpose. Yes? And then you said, okay, my next goal is to make it to Santa Fe. I should say New Mexico. And when if you arrive there, then you may go to Amarillo, Texas. And then, of course, Little Rock, Arkansas. All of these are in a direct alignment with going east. And then finally to Atlanta, Georgia. And if you kept clear on your purpose and you kept clear on your vision, then those goals would be a natural effect of you being on purpose. How many people are with me? So when you set up the goals in alignment with your vision or your purpose and you arrive at your goal, that's how you know you're still on purpose. So then what about getting healthy? You may say, okay, I want to lower my heart rate. That's one of my goals. I want to lose 10 kilos. I want to have more energy. I want to wear a new wardrobe and have a new relationship. This is the short-term goal at the beginning, and the long-term goal is at the end. And as long as you keep making the same choices, demonstrating the same behaviors, reproducing the same experiences, feeling the same way, you'll arrive at all of those goals. What about becoming abundant? You may say you want to be wealthy, and to me it doesn't matter. Wealth is a state of mind. You may want to start a new business. Once you start that new business, you may want to hire 2 new staff employees in 6 months. Then you may say you want to buy a company vehicle. And of course, then the next one is buy a new house. And then ultimately what? Make $1 million? Why not? If that's your goal, to reflect your purpose, then you should arrive at it. Are you still with me? How about learning knowledge? Is there ever an end to knowledge? You may want to get an associate's degree. And then you may want to get a bachelor's degree. And then you may want to get a master's degree. You may want to get a doctorate degree. And then you may want to finally do research. But all of those things are in alignment with your purpose, is it not? So what about this, exploring space? Could you then, we placed the monkey in a spaceship. That was our first goal. Then we created satellites. And then we made it to the moon. And now we got technology to explore Mars. And then, of course, a distant planet. And ultimately, enter the galaxy.